Okay, das kann weg.
Hi Alex.
Hi, hi. How are you?
I'm fine. You?
Yes, too. Thank you. Awesome, awesome. Okay, let me set up everything. And then we can straight up start.
Okay.
Good, good, good. So everything seems to work just fine. Nice. Okay. Good. Do you want to start with the playing or with the replays?
Maybe with the replays. I like to how to say analyze, analyze something, or I like to receive advice. I don't know, but replays is good.
Okay. Okay. So we go into replays first, and then we do the gaming. I think that's good.
Okay.
Okay. So I do invite you to the party. And then we start.
Okay.
Nice. Okay, that's gone, that's gone. Good. So I do think overall that the most issues you have currently with your play style is general. You know what you are doing and what you want to do, so you have a plan, which is good, but you fail in constant production and multitasking. So maybe we can work on that today.
Okay.
So that you get a feeling for when to do what and just constantly producing units. If you open the production tab, you can press D on your keyboard. This should bring up the production tab.
Okay.
Oh, good. And then you can see that you for just look at the production tab for how long you did not produce an SCV. Okay. Wait. Still not done. Okay. So now there's the orbital command. This is fine. And then look. Now it finishes up. 1:55. And it takes you 10 seconds. 15 seconds, almost 20 seconds before you produce another SCV. In that time, you could have had two more SCVs already.
It's more important to do SCVs or try to do a wheel order?
Normally, SCVs. Non-stop,
SCVs, okay.
All the time, produce not only SCVs but production in general, like making marines, getting your upgrades, SCVs of course, and the mules. Very important, the mules. You see, your orbital commands have a lot of energy, and the later you throw down the mule, the later you get the minerals. So your build will be not as crisp as it could be. And you will just have less units to attack or defend, which makes it really difficult for you to win overall. So now your production is looking quite fine. so far? Because now you're focusing at home. When you weren't producing a lot, you were busy with your Reaper. Like against the Zerglings, you were microing your Reaper. And then you didn't, for now, for example, you're not producing anything. Nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Now you start getting back into your production. And I think this is what we should focus the most on today's 2 hour lesson, that we go into as many games as possible. And I just drill you, I would say, to constantly make units. So I will tell you, now throw down a mule, make SCVs, get a barracks, get a supply depot, those basic things, just for you to get used to it and get faster. And it will be stressful, but that's how it has to work. I mean, I have to push you to your limits in order for you to improve.
Okay.
But it's totally fine. If you want to get mad at me and rage and scream, do it. It's totally fine. I am here to do exactly that. To force you, to stress you out, not too much, but just to push you on your limit. And we will definitely do this. Why did you pull? Oh no, this was so perfect. You saw it with the Marines? Wow, that was so good. So you kill all the Banes with some sick focus fire, and then you lift off for no reason at all. But this was a really good fight. Okay. But at home, if you see, no SCVs. You're not producing anything currently. No Marines, no Medivacs, no Widow Mines, no SCVs. And that's what we will focus on. We will try to do both. That I now pull back, and I tell you, make SCVs, and then you have either to jump back or use the control groups. You can see your orbital commands have lots of energy, so much energy. Oh my god. All those juicy mules, or scans if you need them. So now, you normally want to be on 100 supply now, and you are on 64. And if you can manage you to get constantly on 100 supply at the 7-minute mark, I think you will instantaneously get platinum 2 or maybe even platinum 1 just because of that basic skill you will get. I don't know if he will be able to manage to do it today, because it takes a lot of practice for you. I can tell you what to do, but it's your fingers. You have to do most of the work. That's the thing. So depending on how good you are basically, or how good you get today, that depends on how far you will get today, but we will see.
Okay.
So I think there is not really much to tell about those games, other than production. You know, with the armory and the double eBay, basically you could use the idle worker trick. So it's more, most of it is definitely macro.
In this game, I use, for example, your trick about supply depot.
Mm-hmm.
I tried.
It worked quite good for you. Ah, it's so sad. Look,
How do you in this case? Well, you send the SCVs for repair.
Yeah.
But in exact, I don't know in what moment they stop.
Yes, you have them on auto repair.
How do you do it in that moment?
So the
you need to concentrate in this missile tower.
Yeah.
All the time saying send for repair.
I see. Okay. So initially you did very well defending the missile turret. So with the repair, but
yeah,
you had the SCVs on auto repair, and as soon as the turret is on full health again, they will stop repairing the turret and start repairing themselves. If you watch closely at your missile turret, look very closely at your missile turret. Now it's at full health, bam, and they stop and repair each other. That's why auto repair in this situation is not that great. And then he starts to focus firing your SCVs as well. So the missile turret is not there to kill all the mutalisks, but to give you time to react and pull your Marines. The missile turret is just there to give you time to react, not to defend the mutalisk itself.
But in this case, I pull all the army with, for example, F2.
Yeah.
But leave the other orbital control orbital control. It is cool. I have to maybe have a control group.
Yeah. You definitely need to use control groups. Interestingly, you are still in a very good spot, I would say. Upgrade wise, it's looking awesome. 2-1 against 0-0 soon. So technically, you still have a very good chance winning this game, even though he's doing a lot of damage with those circlings. Yeah, that's sad. You also forgot combat shields for your marines. That's a big issue here. Do you win this game? Do you know? Do you remember?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, nice. Killing all the banelings. Yeah, I think that's game. Yeah, definitely. Okay. Okay, yeah, I would say we go into playing. That should be best. And then let's just see how that works out. I don't have anyone. Yeah.
I leave the replay. Sorry.
No, it's good. It's good.
It's good. Okay.
Yeah. What's happening here? Yeah. Placement matches. Okay, so we go into Archon mode now because I don't have anyone on NA you could play against, and I don't think we would find someone now on your skill level in a short time.
Okay.
But it's okay. It's not so much about winning those games now. It's more about just improving your overall skill, and we will definitely get there. So even if you lose all the games, because now basically what will happen is you are playing alone against two other guys. This is Archon mode. Normally I would play two, but I'm the coach. I'm just telling you what to do, and you do it.
Okay.
And then we are fine. So if you lose, don't feel bad. If you win, feel awesome, because you just did then beat two guys alone, basically. So we will see how that works. Okay, nice. Found an opponent already. Nice. I have to say, I think I have never done this. Okay, so it is a TVT. Okay. Do you have a build order in TVT, or do you just?
Yeah, I have idea for I saw the your replay about Helions and how do you say
Reaper?
Replay you was coaching? I don't know.
Yeah. So you wanna play that build?
Okay.
No, it's fine. Good, so another SCV. SCV before the refinery, normally.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just typed them. Okay. But it's okay. Small things, it's fine. So, then barracks and saturate the gas. Okay, another SCV. And then the next refinery. Yep, nice. So far it's looking really good. Okay, saturate the refinery. Normally with this build you don't have to scout, but it's okay, you can still do it.
Maybe how to say?
No, yeah, the SCV you're doing now, normally you don't produce it, but it's, yeah. Reaper factory. And then supply depot and close the wall.
Good.
Yep, there we go. Okay, so your SCV on the other side, you saw there's a marine up there, you don't need to go up. It's closed, so you can send it back. Mule and SCV, another Reaper. Okay. Open one depot. Yes, nice. Okay, so far it's looking good. And then Hellion and the starport. Hellion, starport. Yes. And the SCV who comes back can build our supply depot. On the cliff right here, for example.
Yeah.
Yep. Another Reaper. Another Hellion. SCV. And now attack move with your three forces there. Just attack move, it's fine. Okay. Another SCV. Okay. So now it's getting dicey. Let's see. Another SCV. Then Liberator. Mule. SCV Mule. Yes. Reactor on the barracks. And all five forces go there on top of the ramp. Oh no, the widow mine. Okay, now just park them here up there, it's fine. Yes. Tech lab, more SCVs. Another supply depot. Yeah, you're on it.
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Another SCV. You can get a command center on the low ground. Tech lab on the starport. A cyclone before the tank. Yeah. Oh, there's a medivac. Back. All units back. That's no bad. Produce some marines.
No.
Pull the SCVs back. Don't fight them. Don't fight. No. Care with the Liberator. No, the middle mine! Ooh!
Well, really?
Oh, that's so much damage. Yeah, now you can attack. But it's sad that you lost the. But it's okay. Send them back to mining. Uh oh, carefully. There's still the widow mine. Two Hellions come in. Raise the depots. And maybe scan to clear the widow mine. Yeah, and now kill it. Oh, carefully, the widow mine kills this thing. No, okay, good. Depots, tank, Raven, more SCVs. Raise the depots. Okay, now go to the ramp, defend, and saturate the gases, produce SCVs. Throw down a mule. The other gas, yes, nice. Okay. You could use the Reaper, the Cyclone, and the Hellions to look down. Oh, there's a Banji. Okay, back to your mineral line. The Raven should be out soon. Okay. And now you just need to wait. Produce more SCVs. It's fine. Oh, you get the medivac maybe. Come on. Nice. And there's the Raven. Try to kill the Banji. Get a Viking. And produce more SCVs. Still need to produce more SCVs. Saturate the gases again. You have one mule patrolling at the supply depot. Yeah. Get another Viking and a tank. Just one tank. Okay. Mew down, and then I will produce a reactor now on the barracks and try to get a command center down. So you need that command center soon. Yeah. Ah, Benji in the middle of the line. That's sad. Okay. Produce more SCVs, another tank, and then lift the starport and get... Ah, no, you still need the command center.
What?
Yeah, there's the Banshee, right there. Okay. Tank. Oh, another Banshee. Oh, they are really doing a lot of Banshee shenanigans. There are your, there's your Raven. You should use more the attack command instead of the move command. Cancel the command center fast. Cancel it. Okay. You still need to produce a lot more stuff while you're doing all of this, like another Viking, more tanks, more marines, the command center needs to be rebuilt, but I think you're so far behind now in terms of worker because of those two guys dealing so much damage to you.
Yeah.
Well, against two guys it's really stressful, and they play a very aggressive style of TVT. The bench is in your mineral line now. I think you have a lot of problems with your control groups to keep up with all of the stress, basically. Yes, you have like one or two SUVs now.
Yeah.
So there's the next Banshee. All you can do now is go for a massive all-inch, just pull all your units and attack and hope for the best and macro up behind, but basically I think that's most likely over. But maybe you can still win. So if you pull everything and attack, move towards that location, maybe you can do something. But you need to go now.
I tried to do something.
Just try it. I mean, it's not over yet. And then, of course, produce, get more, yeah. Siege your tanks! Where's your Raven? Oh no, it died! No, your Raven. Oh! Okay, that's bad. That's not good. They will definitely catch that. There they are. Yeah, I think we can go out now. That's GG. It's okay. So let me just switch my overlay so I can see your control groups, and then we can maybe fix something while looking at the replay shortly.
All the time I have my general army in speed. Mm-hmm. Two, four, especially one is so far. I can use one. Sometimes I use, but difficult to use one, two, three.
Yeah. Let me just look what those guys were, because it said they had four KMMR. I'm not quite sure. They were quite good, and you were basically 1v2 against those. So I just wanna shortly look what they are. Archon, yeah, they are pretty. X-Master, 10 times Master. So don't feel bad about that game, they were really good. But we still can work with that, so let's see.
Maybe I lose the game with a widow mine in a first push. It's important to ally, maybe.
Yeah. The widow mine was was not nice that there was the widow mine.
Yeah.
Did you I don't see, wait, do I see? Ah, okay, I see your control groups now. So let's see. 4, 5, 3, that was the scouting SCV, okay. So far everything looked good. Even if you would have gone up there, no. The factory was, you wouldn't have seen it, so don't worry. Okay. Ah, okay. So the first thing you could do is put the factory and the starport and the barracks all in one control group instead of three separate ones. And then use the tab tabulator key to switch through them.
I was trying, but it's so more difficult. Maybe I maybe 5, 6, 7 is easy for me.
Okay.
It's more easy for me.
I just think that you won't go to 5, then press A for all the barracks, then 6, and then SS for tanks, and then 7, and then whatever it is for what you want to produce there. If you use the tabulator key, you just need to use the control group once instead of 3 times for each production cycle you want to go through. So this will, if you use it, I mean, it's totally up to you, but if you want to use all of those in one control group, what it does for you, if you get used to it, is it reduces the amount of APM you need for the same task by a lot. So it will make it a lot easier, I would say, if you get used to it later on. It's totally up to you, of course. If it works for you now, that's fine. I just think later on you will need all of your attention elsewhere, and then you don't have time to press 5 and all the hotkeys for the Marines and the Marauder, and then 6, and then go to the barracks instead of the tabulator key, which is even nearer, I would say. But hard to tell.
Maybe it's more easy. Yeah, I think that, but it's so hard to to accustom Bray again.
That's true. Okay, so what we did learn now is one very important thing. You lost a unit here to the Widow Mine. And yeah, we parked our units there because I told you so. That was maybe not the best move, to be honest. There was no way to go into the natural and deal damage. We really should have pulled back. And sadly, I didn't catch it. Look at that. You could have seen the medivac. If you look at your Hellion, the Hellion barely sees it. Barely. Just, it's so close. Okay. So the first thing you should do every time is use the attack command to move your units, not the move command. If you would have done this, the Liberator would have attacked the medivac. You see how now it's because of the rally point.
Yeah.
But normally what you want to do is, as soon as the Liberator pops out, basically you put it in your control group for your army, be it 1 or 2 or 3, and then attack move to the same location. The rally point is just that it goes there, and just in case you forget about it, but normally this shouldn't happen. This drop is a shame. It's really bad that that did happen. The real problem with the control groups comes right now, I guess. I think you use a lot of the all army hotkey, and you never use the attack command. You always move command. So the first thing you should do is use the attack command every time you move with your units.
Yeah, I use it, but in this case, mm-hmm. I think Maybe I was safe. I safe, but
Yeah. No,
I might
basically
my
every
forward.
time, I mean, if you want to scout with a repo or so, really scout, then it's okay to not use the attack command. But normally if you use your arm, if you move your arm, you want attack move all the time. And in order to defend the Banshee, so first thing, I think the Raven is quite late. But that's because of because of the medivac drop. But then, as soon as the Raven pops out, what you should do is the Raven should be on a separate hotkey than your army. So your army should be maybe on one and the Raven on two. But what I do in my games is I do have the Raven and the Vikings on the hotkey two and all the ground-based army on one. And this gives me the option to use the Raven and the Vikings against the Banshees, while I can save my ground army. If you use the all army hotkey all the time, you can see it now when the Banshee comes back. You were completely stressed and out of position the whole time. Also, your Viking was a bit late here in this game because of the early drop and all the harass. But yeah, not normally now you only need the Raven and the Cyclone or the Raven and the Viking to defend. And if you have those in one control group, you don't move the rest of your army as well. But I think we just try this again. The sad thing is, if you play Archon mode, I don't see your control groups. This is the sad part. The interesting part is that you still are almost even in army supply. Even though they dealt massive damage and you didn't produce constantly, sadly. But even though you still were quite even in army supply. So just imagine you would be even better in constantly producing. Maybe you could have still won the game. I don't think so because you lost so many SVs, but it could have been the case. So if you work on that definitely should help a lot. And as I said, those two guys, they were both X-Master, so it's totally fine to lose against those guys. Yeah, that's the thing with the Archon mode, you know. You were not playing only one master, but two. And that's you know, so that's totally fine. Okay, ready when you are. And then we just try this constant production thing again.
Yeah, how do you do for have a constant production? Do you have in this game you need practice and practice, I know, but I don't know how do you learn so fast for have a production and production a good have a good production? How do you think how do you do for good production? Practice and practice, only that.
Basically, I mean, there are two things. One thing is the mechanic aspect, like being really fast on the keyboard and the mouse. The other thing is the mental component, where you constantly need to think about, I need to produce, I need to produce. Supply depots, SCVs, Marines. This is at least in the beginning, if you learn to constantly produce, it really helps if you, maybe you should record your own voice. Tell you every 12 seconds, build an SCV, build an SCV, like in your head. Every 29 seconds, build a supply depot, build a supply depot, and then you constantly just think about it, and then you do it. And at some point, you don't need to tell it yourself because you automatically are doing it. This is when muscle memory comes into play. If you do it long and often enough, suddenly you just will do it automatically, and then you don't need to think about it anymore. But as you said, it takes a lot of practice. Like there is this wisdom. To be a master, you need to put 10,000 hours into something. Like, if you want to be a master at StarCraft 2, you need to play 10,000 hours of StarCraft 2. If you want to be a master in architecture, you need to spend 10,000 hours constructing buildings. Basically, it shouldn't take that long for StarCraft 2, but you need to practice a lot, basically. That's just how this game works. It's not Minesweeper or Minecraft, where you can log in once in a week and you're fine. StarCraft 2 is different.
Yeah.
Definitely. I would say we just try this again with the constant production in the next game.
Okay.
Yeah, should work better now. I mean, we just played against the Master, so as soon as we might get some Platinum guys, it should immediately get better. Just because of that. Because even if there are two guys, it is unlikely that there is a Banshee left and right and the attack at the front. Very unlikely. At least not that hard. Or at that speed or whatever. What I wanted to try here, that's the problem with Arco mode. If you have a practice partner, it works better because he is basically on the same skill level you are. Then he is, if he attacks basically, that's the thing. For example, if he attacks, he will slip macro like you do as well. And then you would see the difference better if you constantly produce and he doesn't. While in Archon mode you play two guys, so one is producing all the time and the other one is doing the attacks, which makes it more difficult.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I could ask in general chat. So I just ask in general chat, maybe we find someone. This would be better for practice reasons. So let's see. I mean, there are 177 people online in this chat, so maybe one of them has time. But so far it's not looking good. Even on Europe, the problem is all my friends there, all my contacts are master as well. It wouldn't make much sense to play against those.
Okay, but if you want to go to Europe,
I mean we could try, but there are less people in on Europe in general chat than here. So what do you think stresses you the most so that you forget about producing?
Yeah. I in that moment I know I wasn't produce. It's good for me for
Yeah.
I don't take attention, but if you told me about you need this, you need this. Is that really time for do
that. Yeah. It's basically no matter if you attack or defend or do anything, in between it should only take 1 or 2 seconds to get a production cycle going while you are defending, for example. But it's really difficult. Okay, so let's see TVP here.
Yeah.
Okay. What do you play against Protoss normally?
Yeah, really, I try to finish so fast finish. I try to fast finish because it's difficult to go to that late game, middle game for me.
Okay. But your opening, is it 16 Marine drop or Widowmine drop or Cyclone or whatever?
Is Marines, tanks,
Okay.
we don't mind.
Okay, then let's try this. Okay. So you do play gas first. Okay. Cancel, yeah, exactly. So you can saturate the gas now. Bing bing. Second gas. So you stay on one base for quite some time with this build, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you don't need to SCV scout if you do this. Basically. You could when your barracks finishes. Yeah, I would say when your barracks finishes, you should SCV scout. So you can send the SCV who builds the barracks for scouting.
Maybe I need.
Okay. Orbital command. And now you see that your supply depot is too early. You can't get the factory right now. The factory is late.
It's early for I don't
Yeah, I know for him to not scout it, but
yeah
I don't
it's
know
early.
if it's really worth it. It depends, but yeah, maybe. Okay, command center finishes. New SCV is idle. Yeah, there you go. Okay. Another SCV, and then let's see what your scouting SCV does. Okay, there's a Nexus. Awesome. No, go in, see the gases. Check his pylons. Okay, barracks is finished. Another SCV. Okay, another supply depot. Okay, there's one gas, two gas, only one pylon so far. Another SCV, starport, and then whatever you wanna go, yeah, that's good. Okay, Nexus finishes, there's the pylon. Okay, you can get another supply depot right now, again, you will need it. And a mule. Okay. So then, oh, two Widow mines, okay. SCVs, supply depots, more Marines. Then your factory is finished. More Marines. Another SCV. So now your units are not attack moving. No attack. Kill the adept. Ah, you won't get it. No, you won't get it. The adept is faster than your marines, so you don't need to chase it. Trade it away. It's gone. Starport is finished producing. You can throw down a mule, get another supply depot. More SCVs. Mule. You can throw down a mule and produce more SCVs again. Ah, oh, the adept comes into your main base, scouts everything. You need to turn back with your tank. Oh, get the mothership core. Nice. Oh, back up. And now defend back at home. Okay, good scan. So send back the SUVs to mine. Mining. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Your factory could potentially produce more. You have too many SCVs and marines in your barracks queued up. So maybe another supply depot. There is an observe on top of your army. You can scan it. Yeah, nice. Try to kill the pylon. You killed the mothership core, maybe it's still dead. But be careful. Okay. No, it's fine. Tank is good. Siege the tank. Yeah, there you go. Produce more stuff back at home. Maybe a cyclone, another liberator, or a medivac. Just produce. Produce, produce, produce. Okay, nice. Carefully. Oh, nice. Okay, good. The immortal is popped. Another supply depot. Siege the tank. And now kill. Oh, yeah. Okay. If he really attacks, try to kill the sentries and the immortal first. Yeah, nice focus fire. You get it? Back off. Okay, produce more stuff. Maybe you wanna get a command center behind now. Oh, he shades in. Kill the immortal. Okay. Retreat back to your liberation zones. Ooh, ah, that's sad. Yeah, that's a good liberation zone. And the last liberator. Oh no, we got so many stalker. Yeah, now basically your push is over. And you didn't kill the Nexus. That's not looking too good. You also have too many Marines queued up in your barracks. Do you look back at home when you produce units?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You never should do this. With the control groups, you don't need to look at home to produce units. You can just click the control group and then the barracks, for example, is selected and then just produce marines. You don't need to look at home to produce units.
No, I try to do something mm-hmm. different.
Yeah.
Don't return for produce. I make a control group.
Yeah.
No need for
okay.
That. I'll only check my.
The adept comes into your main base. Oh, that's sad. That nasty adept. Okay, send your army back to the front. And as soon as the command center finishes, you can mule down. Oh, there he comes. He baited you. You might still win this fight. Kill the immortal? Yeah. Get stim, produce more units. Oh, don't siege.
No siege?
Not in this situation. You had nothing to buffer. And they are strong with single target. You shouldn't. In this situation, you shouldn't have sieged. Yeah, this is no game.
Yeah.
Okay, so
I attack. I don't know. Normally, I do more damage.
Mm-hmm.
But in this case, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe play very well this guy.
The thing is, your build order was It can be a bit better. Just some small adjustments, which would have made this push way stronger. First of all, this map should definitely be on veto as a Terran. But it's fine for now. So in this case, what I want to know is where you did look when the adepts did shade in. And of course, yeah, so first of all, this supply depot. I know you don't want him to scout, but what it does is your factory is just way too late. Especially on a map where you have to move that long. If he scouts it, he will scout it, no matter what. I mean, if you block it with a supply depot and he doesn't scout anything, he will know that something is coming. So however you do it, he knows that something is coming. So that's why you just don't block it, the scouting. Normally.
Okay.
I wouldn't go with the supply depot. Normally, just 19 orbital command, one marine, then I think it's one marine, then the... Well,
after that reactor.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Yes, one marine, then reactor, factory, of course, a widow mine, and after the first widow mine, you get the tackler for the tank. And the first unit you get is, I think it was the medivac. You get one medivac to heal your units, but also to micro your tanks. And after the medivac, you go for liberator non-stop and marines non-stop. After the first tank, you get one cyclone, and after that, it depends if you wanna go into more cyclones with the upgrade. I think it's good against air, but I'm not against Stargate. And if he doesn't go Stargate, I think you go more tanks, if I remember correctly. But so far, this was okay, and yeah. So the eBay is a nice adaption here for the turrets. I mean, there are two ways to play this. You can play it as a full all-in, so, or just as a very aggressive push. But normally it's a very aggressive all-in. Yeah, they had lots of gates. Look at that, 5 gate economy. Okay. Oh yeah, and the adept went in. So instead of the eBay, even though the eBay is nice, so what you definitely need is bunker for the marines and then push slowly. We totally forgot about the bunker here in this game. So that scan was good. And now comes the tanks. Let me see, where did you look when the adept shaded? Because for now it's looking awesome. This is a really strong push. Okay. If he moves in like that, just look. If he moves in like that to attack your liberator right now, you should use your marines, not retreat, but go just a little bit up to buffer, to make it harder for your opponent to kill the liberator. So the marines, they are somewhat of a meat shield, but only to distract. You shouldn't lose those. So this is very difficult. They have to tank some damage, but not too much to die. Just so that if the stalker attack your liberator, they take a lot of damage from the marines. And if they attack the marines, you just retreat back and the liberator deals the damage with the tanks. And then you jump back and forth all the time. And if he doesn't commit at all, you just kill his nexus. And then push slowly forward again and again with another bunker. And what you also do is never unseage all your tanks or liberator at once. Just one tank at a time and one liberator at a time. Never all at once. So here he took a lot of damage. Then you kill the mothership core again. This is looking so good. And now?
Yeah,
Yeah, now you look
I had.
back. I think. Where are you looking? Is this you? Is this no, this is you. Okay, let's see. What happens now? What does happen now? Okay, you unseat one tank. Yeah, against the adept you definitely needed the bunker. So you kill all his stalker and you get the immortal, and this is awesome. And now, instead of going towards his nexus, you follow him somewhat. You see how he dances back and forth and avoids the liberation zones?
Yeah.
That's the bad part. You still could have dealt a lot of damage, but now he has five. That's the problem. If you play your aggressive style, which is awesome, it can work really good, but you're not allowed to lose all your units because then your push is over and the game is gone. He has five gates, so he can outproduce you. And the only way to win is because you have the better tech with Liberator, tanks, medivacs, cyclones, widow mines, marines and bunker and counter repair. His production eventually will get better than yours, so you have to have the better army and take the better engagement to win, which you can. In this game it didn't went too well. So if you find another Protoss, let's just try another game. With the production it went better. I still think we should try to refine your build a little bit and get the constant production going. It is difficult. You have to look at the front while back at home constantly producing stuff. And this is what we need to get you used to, that you do this all over again. I really think I think, to use the control groups and put the barracks and the factory and the starport in the same group. I
Okay.
think it does help a lot. I really would just give it a try. Maybe two or three games. And if you then say, nope, sorry, it doesn't work, then it's fine. But at least you tried it. And if it works, even better.
Okay.
So just give it a shot.
Okay.
Just try it.
Okay.
So let's hope we can find another opponent. I will ask in general chat again, but so far.
Normally, Protoss go to the high ground and destroy the natural base, but in this case, they defend that.
Yeah, they defended quite well. I really think we lost there because of the bunker. If you would have had two bunker there, that what was missing. And the build order was not that crisp. Like one widow mine is enough at
Yeah,
first.
I lose one widow mine freely. Yeah, it's important to keep alive.
Yeah, and with the factory as well, the push would have hit like I would say 10 seconds earlier, which is a lot. Early in the game, 10 seconds is like it's so much. In the early game, if you play this kind of attack, every second counts.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm still asking guys in the general chat. So far, it's not looking like they want to play, but never mind. Found another one. Okay, TVT again. It's good. We can try this the build again.
Yeah.
Yep.
So concentrate in
Yes,
activities is good.
this time
Other
if he.
other day, yes, it's good.
Mm-hmm.
It's fine.
Awesome. So let's see how this works. Okay, good luck, have fun. Okay. And always get the SCVs before you build a structure. So if you have to choose between a refinery and SCV, SCV goes first. It's not a big issue here, but it's a minor detail. So now you can get the refinery. Yeah, there you go. Nice. So next SCV. And then I would place the barracks like that you can produce the add-on straight away so that you don't have to lift it. So just two tiles from your normal spot. Okay, never mind. Saturate the gas, get another refinery. Yeah, there you go. Okay. You can set the rally point from your barracks right here.
Here?
Yep, perfect. Another SUV, good, there we go. Then saturate the refinery. 1, 2, nice. Okay. So now the orbital command, next. Then the factory and then the Reaper. Factory before the Reaper normally.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's okay. Supply depot at the front. And he scouted. It can be that he's annoying now with the SCV, so you need to pull another one, maybe, and attack this one. Yeah, I think so. Okay, orbital command finishes. New SCV. You can pull your SCV back and let the Reaper attack the SCV. Get another Reaper. Yeah, his SCV is right here. You have one idle SCV. Yes, his. Yeah. Okay. Hellion, starport. Starport, starport, starport. Yeah, and supply depot. And another. Oh, he comes in at the front. So what you can do is you can say carefully, yeah, nice, okay, and attack him. Yeah, now he's dead. Reaper, Hellion, SCV. Ah, there comes another Reaper. You can attack move now into the bush with everything, it's okay. Another supply depot, SCV, Mew. Okay, then another Hellion. Liberator. Okay, pull everything into the bushes. Then get the reactor, another SCV. Reactor on your barracks?
Reactor?
Yeah, reactor on your barracks. So now with your Hellion and your Reaper, maybe go there. Because the Liberator. Then tech lab on the factory. Okay. You have two idle ones. Yeah, there you go. Okay, now you wait with all your units out there for the Liberator to pop out and move across the map right here. Tech lab. Cyclone. Command center. Mule. Not two cyclones. Yeah, one. Command center. Then Mule. Marines. Raven, set the rally point back to your main base. More SCVs. Okay, Liberator goes now in, and the Hellion and the rest attacks right there, while your Liberator attacks there.
Okay, I go to attack.
Yeah, Liberator siege up the mineral line, and the rest attacks the natural, and then constant produce behind of it. So now your command center gets attacked. Need to defend that, it's okay, send another SUV down. Oops. Yeah, more marines. Another supply depot. Viking. And then we want to do this attack, which is now a lot late, but it could still work. Attack, always attack move. Okay, back, 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 back. Back, back, back. And the Liberator can't do much here. But it's okay, just retreat back. You're still good. Get another tank. All units to the ramp. Mule, supply depot, SCVs, two additional barracks, another tank. Two barracks?
Barracks.
Yep, two barracks. And your army should be on that side of the ramp. Yeah. Okay. Orbital command. Rally down SCVs. Saturate. Rally point from the command center down. Good. Another supply depot could be used soon. Then lift the starport, get a reactor. Oh, you get an attack! Your army! Yeah, that's... You didn't pull back. Ah, that's sad. Okay. Everything to the ramp. You should plant maybe a turret there. With the Raven. Yeah. Maybe another one. He comes. It's not looking good. I think we need to do something else here to get you used to the constant production. You know what we're gonna do?
Yeah.
We go into custom games and let's see one game against the AI just to see how your general would do this. I think this is too much here with the constant pressure against two guys. It's looking still quite okay, but you take so much damage. You can still win this. So you get stim, you get another tank, go for two refineries. You can throw down a third command center. Totally. Yeah, go up to a fifth barracks. Throw down mules. Yeah. More medivacs. More marines. Get another reactor on the barracks. Yep. Okay, another tank. Saturate the gases. Produce more SCVs. And get some SCVs from your main to your natural. It doesn't make a lot of difference here, but yeah, they're oversaturated. You still need a fifth barracks. And then you can go double eBay. Oh, you have one eBay. No, it's fine. We stay on one eBay. It's good. No, it's good.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Don't cancel. It's whatever. it's okay. Reactor on your barracks? You still need the fifth barracks. Yeah. Another barracks, more units, tanks, marines. You could queue up combat shields, just that you don't forget it. Okay, you still need the barracks, the fifth one.
Alright.
Yeah. Okay, more units, more... get a command center, orbital command. Yes. Okay, he scans. You should pull your army to this location. And produce. Maybe send one marine into this bush here. So that we know what's going on there. Just for that he comes. Yeah, nice. Okay, produce more units. Combat shields for your marines. And plus one armor. Yeah, there we go. Another supply depot. And more units. Tanks, marines, more medivacs. More marines. More mules. More SCVs. Okay. And then reactor on your barracks. Then take both gases. Yes, nice. Get another factory. And oh, he attacks. Okay, now that's just a drop. And you should be able to clear this. Nice. Okay. There's a tank on the low ground, which you should kill. Yes, get three more barracks and another eBay and another armory, and produce units all the time, supply depots and units non-stop. More marines, yes, nice. Another tank, more medivacs. Then finish the refinery, more supply depots. You need the second eBay. Yeah. You can go for two supply depots at a time now. Tech lab on your factory. More marines, more tanks, more medivacs. Okay. You still need the refineries at your third base. Reactor on your barracks, on all of them. And a fourth command center. And then +2/+2. The problem is, oh, your gases in the natural are not saturated properly. And in the main base. And in the third base. Everywhere, gas is missing. So he scans again, he might just attack again. Maybe a big doom drop comes in. You could +2/+2 for your army, and +1 weapon upgrades for your tanks. And marines, and more supply depots. Bam, bam, bam. Like 2 or 3 supply depots. You can call down supply as well now, it's fine. Yeah, call down. Yeah, and then produce more marines, all the barracks, and more tanks. You wanna have everything. Okay, scan his army. Yeah, siege your tanks. Oh, pull back, pull back. Ooh, that was a bad start, but we can still be fine. Now you need to work with your Raven and your Vikings against his force. What you can do now is load up like 4 medivacs with marines, only marines. Oh, he tore drops. Yeah, nice. Okay, load up 4 medivacs with after the scan. So still producing. Siege your tanks. Okay, now load up 4 medivacs with marines.
Okay.
Yep.
4
medivacs with marines. Or 5, doesn't matter.
And? Roba?
Yeah, marines. Only marines in the medivacs. Yeah, there you go. Bam, bam, bam. Okay. And then you take them. Let's have some there. It's fine. Okay. Produce more stuff. Maybe scan right here. Oh, he's not there. Okay, now you need to be careful with your medivacs. You should just unload them here right now on the left-hand side of the map. Just unload. Don't commit. You don't know where his army is. They will just die. Just unload. Take your fourth base. Produce more stuff. Get +3/+3 and +2 weapons. And then saturate your fourth base. So upgrades.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is. Okay, now relocate your army. Lift the command center, you can't hold this. Siege the tanks. Pull back. Don't fight in his tank fire. Okay. And now drop right here. Or even no, drop in his main base. Drop in his main base and produce. You're not unloading. No. Okay, there you go. Good. And now look back at home. They will do their stuff, it's totally fine. Don't care of those marines. Just produce, produce, produce. Maybe scan his army, what he got there. Ah, okay. If you got enough marines, which you have, you can drop everything on top of his. Now go attack his tanks. He's unseaching, he's retreating. Now you need to be fast. Okay, I think that's not enough. No. Go back to mining, saturate your bases, you're still fine. And produce, produce, produce. So take your bases again. Produce a lot of stuff. You should get your upgrades. You have three barracks not producing anything. Yeah, there you go. Okay. And more marines. Yeah, there you go. That's what I want to see. And more tanks. You have still tanks and medivacs. And then if the fourth base is secured, you can saturate it with the SUVs from your third base and throw down a lot of mules. You need that. So I would get some SUVs to the fourth base now. Yeah, there you go. Maybe some more. 20 out of 10 is still too much on your third base. Okay. And then throw down mules like 5 or 6 or so. Mules at the fourth base. Not all, but 4 to 6 mules. I would have. Yeah, the fourth base would have been better. Okay, more units. And then we can take everything and attack on this pathway. So now
take
we are maxed
everything?
Out. Yeah, everything. We do an attack now. Okay. So you can buy get 3 more barracks and another factory and maybe another command center now. And attack further. There now. Yeah, there we go. So some more barracks, another factory, maybe 2. We need the production facilities. Okay. And move further with the army. There he comes, Stim! Attack! Stim! Ah! Can you catch him? If you catch him, that's so good. Yes, nice, nice. Go in, go in, go in! Go in! Nice, nice, okay. Produce, produce, produce. More stuff. Stim to win! And produce, and attack. Up his ramp, into his main. Stim! Stim right into his main. Not for the natural, go for the main. Stim into his main. Yeah, there you go. GG!
Yeah.
And you won against 2 guys. Just because you produced stuff. Isn't this nice?
So, yeah.
and now you might see, you still had lots of issues with your production. But you won, basically. Now imagine you wouldn't have any issues with your production. How crazy you would outproduce them. You would totally kill those guys. Like, totally. So what I wanted to do now is, I would like to test your macro mechanics in a custom game. Just versus the AI. Like we did it now, just without all the harassment stuff and that you can focus on your macro. And then let's see if you can hit the timings. Okay?
Okay.
Good. So very easy AI. It will do nothing to you. Your Terran looks good. Okay. And then we just try to being maxed out. Yeah. And I would say we try the TVT build. It's totally fine now. It doesn't really matter which build we play for the macro, but we just pretend it would be TVT now. And yeah, that's then totally fine. So let's see if we can make you 100 supply at the 7-minute mark.
Okay.
just by focusing on macro. So everything you produce, you just rally it other than SCVs. But if you produce Marines, just rally it there or at his base, at his natural, I don't care, somewhere that it's not in your way. Doesn't matter where your units are. You don't need to scout, you don't need to do anything, just concentrate on your macro. And so far this is looking really good. So now you saturate the refinery. Get another refinery right now. Yes. So this refinery is late now because of the SCV, which was the whole time in the queue. Yeah. So you see this build is really crisp. But it's not a big issue here. It's fine. Okay, one more SCV, saturate the refinery, and after that the orbital command. So one more SCV. Oh wait, no, never mind. Not more SCV. There we go. Okay. Factory before the Reaper. Yeah. Because it doesn't matter if the Reaper is 5 seconds late, but it does matter if the factory is 5 seconds late.
Okay.
Command, yeah. the supply depot. Yep. Another Reaper. You can queue it up right now, it's fine. New SCV. Okay. Okay, so Hellion, Starport, and Supply Depot, and another SCV. Starport! Stress. Yeah, okay. SCV, Reaper. Another Reaper? Yeah, there you go. Okay. So. Then another SCV, you already got it, good. Supply depot, right after that, the next one. Nice. Okay. SCV, mule. Hellion. Liberator. Idle SCV. Okay. Reactor, SCV. Okay, good. Maybe you need another supply depot, I think. Yeah, I think so. SCV, tech lab. Okay, and then you can soon go for a command center at the natural. So, tech lab and cyclone. Yeah, Cyclone, Tech Lab, SCVs, Marines. Okay. And another supply depot and a mule. There we go. Mule. Okay. Raven, SCV, more Marines, SCV. Oh. Yeah. Okay, good. Tank. Another supply depot. Ah, your mule is not mining. No! Misclick. Okay, another SCV. More Marines. Okay. It's looking quite good so far. Then you can saturate your natural, get a Viking. Yeah, Viking, there you go. More SCVs. Orbital command? Oh, orbital command first. That's the most important part. Cancel the tank. That's okay. Yeah. Then tank, Marines, SCVs. Always SCVs and mules. And set the rally point from the main base to the natural. And put two SCVs to the natural as well. You want to have perfect saturation. Okay. So another tank, reactor on your starport, another barracks, mule, and more SUVs. Always SUVs. Reactor on your starport. The third barracks is still missing. You need the third barracks. You want that. And then of course supply depots. Two at a time now. Okay. And more SUVs, there you go, nice. Okay. Yeah, that's looking good. More SUVs. Stim. And more supply depots. Saturate the gases at the natural. And then you can start with more Vikings. Okay, then add-ons on the barracks, more SCVs, mules, more supply depots, constant supply depot production. And we are 100 supply at the 7-minute mark. Was a bit crocky, but it's still okay. Okay, add-ons. Normally you go for add-ons first on your barracks before you produce units.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And then just produce more stuff here. Also more medivacs now, you can go into medivacs now, it's fine, tanks, more supply depots. Okay, and then next command center. And throw down mules, SUVs, command center, where is it? Right, nice. So more SUVs, more medivacs. Medivacs and supply depots. Yeah, nice. Good with the supply depots. And more units. Marines, Marines, Marines. Okay, another tank, maybe. Another mule, you can mule. And again, supply depots. Okay, nice. And again. Oh no!
What happened?
Misclick. It's okay. So, more units. Units, units, units. Okay. Then saturate the third base, orbital command, and again, mules. So from your second base, yeah, there you go. Maybe two more. You want to have perfect saturation. Okay. Maybe three more, four more. Okay. Now it's looking quite okay. So now you basically need only one more supply depot and then you are done with building supply depots?
One.
One is enough now. And then you could go for more barracks and another factory. So now we did totally skip upgrades and the production was late, but still. With better mark. No, it's fine. The thing is, You can see now for yourself how much practice basically you need or you can use to improve your macro. It would be possible to be maxed out with two upgrades, I would say, on the way right now. It is possible, but it's really difficult. So you would need to practice a lot to be faster, to not miss anything. What I could do maybe after the game, after the coaching, is go for a custom game myself. We also totally forgot about combat shields, you see. Also a big mistake here. And then just I tried to be maxed out at the 10-minute mark with the same build. And then I sent you the replay and you can compare those two replays. The thing you played now against the one I then play, to just see the differences, if that may help you.
Okay.
But yeah, that's basically macro all over the time. How stressful was it for you?
Yeah, a little.
Okay. It would have wondered if not. If it wasn't stressful, I would have done something horribly wrong. But that's basically it. You need to be on point of your timings and constantly hit them to just outproduce your opponent. This is the most important part, just constantly produce. Should we try it again on ladder?
Okay.
I mean, if you want to do something else, you can tell me. If you have enough gaming now and want to focus more on replays now, that's also fine. I'm totally open for everything you want there.
Okay.
Good.
I have problem with engage. If I see tanks, in that moment, I want to focus because not it's in seagull mode. I try to kill them in that moment. It's not a good moment for attack, really.
Yeah, with the with the tanks, the problem with the give me a second. So the problem with the engagement is, like in the last game, before you won, you caught all his tanks. This was so good. But when he attacked you, you were indecisive. You wanted to go in. And then I told you, no, better don't go in, because his marines were at the front. So if his tanks are at the front, you can engage without any risk if your marines are at the front, because they kill the tanks first. And then he has only marines against your marines and tanks. Otherwise, I would take it slowly. You really need to, basically you need to scan his army and then see what does he have and what does you have. Compare this. And then within a split second, you need to know, can I fight or not? If you go in and out and you don't know, should I attack, should I not, you will lose automatically. So either you go in full or you don't at all. And there is no rule, basically, where you can be like, now I can attack or now I can't. You need to scan his army or see his army, compare it to yours. And then also positioning is very important. Like, if you go down a ramp into siege tanks, you will never win. Even if you would have 1,000 marines, you wouldn't win this fight because of the position. So position is also very important. You need to know where to fight and when and how. And this is a lot. So basically, so what you normally want to do as Terran in TVT is you have marines in one control group, maybe one, and then your medivacs with the tanks in the second group for the tankivac mechanic to drop them. So two control groups, one for the marines and the second one for the medivacs, which have the tanks loaded up. And basically it is most of the time, as a basic rule, it doesn't fit completely, but whoever drops his tanks first wins this engagement, basically. Not for 100% sure, but most of the time it is like that. On even armies, that's how it basically works. Then of course concave is important at upgrades, but as a general rule, if you drop your tanks first, you should win. Normally. It still depends of course on upgrades and concave positioning, and the armies need to be equal.
When the other person have many tanks, it's difficult to win. I think for me it's difficult.
Yeah, it is. It is really difficult.
Because I don't concentrate to do tanks. I concentrate to maybe to do upgrades or many marines.
Yeah.
Marauders, but it's difficult to win.
It really is. I would say for you, what you should do is the center turret was a good idea. I would play it safe. So try to get your macro done with the mechanics, but don't focus on micro and engagements too much. Instead, get vision with sensor turrets or maybe some marines, just to know where his army is. You remember the drop we did, the 3-4 medivacs on the left hand side of the map?
Yeah.
So that's what you want to do, basically. Stay defensively, see where his army is, and if he moves out, you have a drop waiting to punch in. And that's where you can deal the most damage without needing a lot of APM or multitasking. You have just 24 marines with 3 medivacs, and if you know his army is on your side of the map, you have the defender's advantage. Your tanks are sieged. You know he's coming. You have a nice concave. You're safe. And then you go in. Bam. And most likely he will have everything on your doorstep. But you're prepared. So if he attacks you, you win. And if he goes back, well, then you deal a lot of damage. And you're still fine. And you can drop somewhere else. And eventually you have so much production that you just can attack, kill your army, remake it in a whole single production cycle, attack again, over and over again. I wouldn't focus too much on engagement and micro and pick up tanks and splitting and all that stuff, because for now it only hurts you in your macro. So instead just try to play it safe, play it strategically, know where he is and where he isn't. And when you know where he isn't, that's where you attack. It's making things much more easier for you.
Okay.
So it doesn't look like we will find someone else. What's going on here? Okay, I'm asking in general chat again. But so far it's not looking good today with those guys. They are all trolling about Trump, and I don't know why. Oh god. I hope we find someone else to play. But the last game we did against with the Terrans, this TVT, even though it wasn't the best, but you saw that it can work.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you had some good production. If you would watch the replay, I think you had more barracks and more factories than they got. And your upgrades were better, I think, as well. Oh yeah, what I saw also, you went for the armor upgrade on your tanks. Don't do that. Just go straight for +3 attack upgrade.
Attack?
Yeah.
Only attack?
Only attack upgrade on the tanks. It is 5 more damage in the siege mode. It is way better than the armor upgrade, because the tanks don't need the armor upgrade because you have the marines to buffer, so they don't take damage. And even if they would be in danger, normally you have medivacs to save them, so in the best case scenario they never take damage, so they don't benefit from armor at all, but they attack all the time. So they have a lot of advantage with the attack upgrade. So just go straight to +3 attack. No armor for tank evacs.
I didn't know. Okay, thanks.
Yeah. I don't know if he finds someone else here to play. It's really messed up. Wait.
When you play with TBT with Marauders, you need to upgrade the Marauders upgrade.
If you play Marauder, definitely. You mean the concussive shell, the slow?
Yeah.
The slow grenade? Yes, of course, definitely. You should get it. As the last, of course, so Stim, Combat Shields,
yes,
and then Concussive Shields. But of course, get it. It's super important. Against Stalker and Adepts, it's good. Against Tanks,
yeah,
it's good. Or Hellbats, yes. Or against Roaches and Ravager, it's also good. Against Banelings, it can work as well, really well. So definitely go for that upgrade.
But in the third upgrade, we have to do.
Yes,
first
yes.
Thing, maybe combat shield,
mm-hmm.
And the third is.
Exactly. Yeah, the concussive shields, yes. Okay, got another game. Hopefully. Come on. No! I thought. Yeah, it's really annoying. Sometimes. I would love to have someone for you to play against, but there's no one online currently. Not really.
Okay, in this moment, I like to maybe practice a mechanic. I have problem with maybe to pick up when you I do drops.
Mm-hmm.
I have problem for pick up very fast. I don't know how to do.
Oh yeah, okay. We can do this. Sure. Okay. That's very good. I like that. Okay, let's go into the unit tester and try it right here. That's very good. Not wasting too much time. You're right. So,
I have a medevac.
Mm-hmm.
It's easy to drop.
Yeah.
Very in line.
Mm-hmm.
But when you have 3-4, I misclick maybe.
Yeah.
Or to do that, I don't know.
I see.
What do you do?
Let's basically the same with the. Let me see. Which one are you? You are blue, so you get the medivacs and a bunch of marines. Okay.
Okay.
So you just what you. No wait. Let me get some as well that I can try this. Okay, so what you basically do is you have some medivacs and some marines. You can load your marines into your medivacs.
Yeah,
you can do it. You are the blue one, I think. The right one?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So just load up
everything?
The medivacs. Yeah, sure. Everything loading up.
Only three, it's okay.
Oh, it's okay to do it with three first. And what you need to do is you need to click. What I do is either you can click the unload button on all three, like press the, for me it's D, three times, and unload each single medivac. Or you press D, hold shift. And click. You need to click each single medivac, and then you can move it around. Yeah, exactly like that. Perfect. That's how it works. And then with speed, of course. You can try this a little bit. You need to be very precise. If you misclick, they will stop unloading and move to the location. That's the problem. So you need to be very precise. On that one, but that's basically how it works. Press D on every single one and then move them around. There is also one trick if you want to that's looking really nice. if you want to upload your marines into your medivacs, what I mean, if you look at my medivacs now, normally what marines do, if you let's see, so you click there. Okay, if you don't use shift at all, they just move to the last medivac. That's not good. You want all of the, come on, stop this. You want all of them loading up at the same time, basically. And with that, you need the stop command. So what I do is I grab my marines, let's say right here. Then I click on the first medivac. Shift through every medivac and press the stop command. It is difficult. Let's do it again. Let's do it together, okay? You grab all your marines.
Okay.
All your marines. Then you hold shift, mm-hmm. right click on each medivac. Wait, no. Wait.
Okay.
Yeah, but they already did it. So shift click through all the medivacs,
mm-hmm.
and they, you see how they will move to each individual medivac.
Yeah.
So with the shift command, you can load up all the medivacs at once. They will separate to the medivacs. Shift. Automatically. Yeah, try it. It should, and that's how it works. Normally.
No, it's not good, I think. Now what? Let's go. I hold shift.
Mm-hmm.
And then
on each medivac, yes. Right click on each medivac, and they should separate. Okay. Themselves. Really nice.
Okay.
This is how it is. And this is way faster. Normally what happens a lot is they move to the first medivac, then it's full, then they move to the second medivac, then it's full, then they move to the third medivac. Takes a lot of time, you lose half the units if you drop your opponent's base, it's bad. But with the shift command, bam bam bam. And the same thing would work for the tanky vacs as well. I would say. Let's see if it works for the tanky vacs as well. If you have a lot of tanks and medivacs and they are sieged. Yeah, you can shift through all of them and they will pick up it individually. But you need to do it with the tanks, not with the medivacs. Yeah, maybe try it. Almost. Ready for pickup? Watch your step. Yeah. So this is how it works with the tank.
But in the engage, do you have to do this?
What you really want to do in an engagement is basically have the tanks being spread out. So you have the tanks and the same thing you did with the marines.
Yeah.
The unload is what you want to do with the tanks. So basically you want to have you could drop them all at once like that. Wait, like that. But that's bad because now all of the tanks are clumped up. They will take a lot of splash damage and they don't cover edge as much ground as they normally would. So what you just do is you basically with a boost, you boost the medivacs and rapid click D on your medivacs, so on the unload button. I don't think that there's, yeah, this one is bugged. I don't think that there's a faster way of spreading them other than doing it with the boost. And then just click the unload on each single medivac. It's not perfect, but at least you have a better split of your tanks. You need to hit the medivacs with the unload button. So if they boost, you just basically you just spam unload button on your medivacs. Like the same thing you do with the marines once, you do there constantly until everything is loaded up. Dropped down, I mean.
I misclick.
Yeah, that's the thing you need to practice there, to hit the medivacs and not the ground. I don't really know if there's a better way to do this. On the other hand, I think it will be patched out soon, so you won't need this mechanic too much, the tank evac mechanic.
But in the next patch, maybe tanky medivac.
Yeah, I think it will be removed. Yes,
you can do that. Only patch. Only I know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But. Okay.
So it should be gone.
When you do drops in this way, the tanks drop forward or back to the marines?
That depends. If you can catch the opponent's marines, you can drop them in front. Normally, you want to drop them. A little bit behind your marines, but not too far away. So, for example, if I would be able with my tanks now to catch a lot of marines, then I would drop them just here and kill the marines, load up everything, and boost back. But normally behind the marines, not at the front. The tanks are not there to tank damage. The marines are there to tank damage for the tanks. And to kill medivacs and be safe against drops and anything. But the tanks normally behind your own marines. I just wonder if there is anything else with the drops I could show you, but I think the most important part was really the rapid unload and the shift retreat. I think that's the most important part there. Yeah, and then of course macro mechanics is the most important part there.
Okay.
Yeah. So normally with the build order I showed you, it depends on the situation. Sometimes I go up to 5 Vikings, sometimes only up to 3. At some point you definitely want to go for medivacs, and then I would go for as many medivacs as you have tanks. I would stop at 12 medivacs, but I saw Hero Marine go up to 16, and I asked him, and he was like, no, 16 is totally fine, it's not too much. So depending on the situation, 16 medivacs can also be okay. But as a general rule, for each tank, have 1 medivac. That's it. And then you have enough medivacs for dropping, healing, picking up your tanks, and you should be fine. And at some point, yes, a Viking can be really good. I wouldn't make too many Vikings. Maybe 3 or 4. Maybe 2. Depends. In later, I mean, if you have medivac tank bio against medivac tank bio. Maybe 1 or 2 Vikings just to get the air control back. I wouldn't make too many Vikings. They are not really good against Marines. And at some point he will just overwhelm you if you make too many Vikings. But 1 or 2 Vikings to push back his medivacs are really good.
Okay. How many barrels do you need for maybe in 10 minutes?
Mm-hmm.
How many barrels do you have to
make
normally? 5, 6?
You wanna have 8 barracks on 3 bases and 2 factories with 1 starport in TVT. If you take your 4th base, depending on the game, if you have enough minerals, you can go up to 12 barracks and 3 factories, because you will most likely be maxed out, and then you start banking up a lot of minerals. So it's good to go up to 12 barracks on 4 bases. So it is 5 barracks on 2 bases with 1 factory and 1 starport. 8 barracks, 7 to 8 barracks, but I would go to 8. And 2 factories and a starport on 3 bases, and 12 barracks and 3 factories and 1 starport on 4 bases. And all of them reactor. Like, one is with the tech lab, of course, because of the upgrades. You can later on switch it to a reactor as well. I would do this, actually. It's really good. Unless you play against mech. If you play against mech, you need more marauder. So I would go up to the same amount of barracks, but 4 tech labs, or maybe 5 tech labs, and 5 tech labs and 3 reactor. So that you have 1 marine and 1 marauder as a ratio. So for each marine, you have 1 marauder against mech, basically.
And the upgrades. When is the moment for the upgrades? You finish the starport? When you have a 1 base, I watch the people know.
Yeah.
Upgrade.
You can
have a 2 base. It start to make a engineering by.
Yeah. So depending on the game, I would in TVT with my build, I think it's smart to go for 1 eBay at like, when your natural is halfway saturated. So like at the 6 minute mark, I would say. 5 minute mark. Five to 6 minute mark. 1 eBay. And then later on you go up to double eBay and double upgrades. So I would start with 1 eBay, because you get tanks and medivacs and all that stuff is so gas heavy, and you also want to get the 3rd command center. I think 1 eBay at first is good. My build is very aggressive, so it's not that economical. If you would play a different build, you can go to 2 eBays, of course, as well. Because you play then more defensively, you have better economy, it works just better. But with the build I'm playing, I would say 1 eBay is most of the time better in terms of constant production.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let me try to do a little engage. You can make a marines and medivacs, maybe 20 for you and 20 for me. You can practice. I can.
Okay. Only marines or medivacs and tanks as well?
Yeah, it's tanks. Don't need only marines and medivacs.
Oh, okay. So, marines.
I
oopsie. Oops, yeah. That's a little bit too much. So. So medivacs. Like okay. That?
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay. Let's do stim and combat shields. And maybe plus 1. So what exactly do you want to test?
Yeah, when I attack, I go forward.
Uh-huh.
But I try to advance, but my marines no attack. Maybe I when you do a click,
mm-hmm.
Where do you do? Behind to enemy? Or enemy?
Yeah, where do I attack move? Normally I attack in front of your army, basically. This is enough.
Because I when I do a forward click,
yeah,
maybe I attack only enemy, only one enemy. In that moment, I lose many marines.
Okay. I would say we just try it and see.
Okay, I try.
So you didn't stim.
I didn't stim. No.
Okay, let's do it again. So now I'm not attack moving at all. I'm just now attack moving. And I don't micro at all at this point. There is no need to micro. If you try the stutter step, it can work. Just don't micro at all. Let's do no micro and just attack move and see how it goes, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Attack move, that's it. Ah, you forgot stim. Let's do it again. You need to stim. Okay. So there we go. It's looking closer already, and you didn't do anything. So I know what you wanted to do. You wanted to stutter step, but against in a marine medivac, against marine medivac situation, you don't need to stutter step. You only need to stutter step when your units have more range than your opponents, or if you want to catch units which have more speed than your own units, basically. That's when you need to stutter step to get the most damage out of your actions. In a situation like this, it would be way better if before the engagement, you just do that. Make a big concave. So you just split your marines a little bit before the engage. It should help a lot if we, split them a little bit more. Make a bigger concave. Okay. Oh no, wait. Let's do it again. Maybe take it like that. That you have a concave like this. Yeah, that's looking good. So, and I clump up now. You just stim and attack move, and I do this now as well. Okay, go. Okay. Attack. Oh no, you didn't pull everything. Ah, you hadn't all your units there. Yeah. Let's do it again. So you split. Okay, let me get into this trap. Wait, unload. Okay. Ready?
Okay.
Go. It should look better now for you. Yeah. That's what you can do. Just do a concave. What will happen then is more of your marines will shoot than mine, and then you win. No fancy micro needed. Just pre-split a little bit, get a nice concave before the engagement.
But when you stay in that engage, you can do that. Or
yeah, of course. I mean,
or lost time, maybe lost time for do that. Maybe it's not important to do in that engage in the moment.
If it's even army, I would more focus on macro in your situation now. I mean, you can try in the fight to get a better concave and micro back marines and maybe medivac pickup marines and such things. But overall, just focus on macro. If the armies are even, you can, of course, you need to have a look on your fight. But before you start fancy micro, it is better to just get an army back at home. Like after the fight, if you have the same army again, it's better as if you win with 10 marines left and have nothing back at home. Then it would be better to lose the fight but have the same army again. Just
The other problem with the engage I have. How do you do? You have your marines or army in a control group, or in that moment you can select a little block, the attack move, for example, or you use a control group for attack. Because if you have
Control group. Definitely,
you
I use the control group.
control group.
Yeah, I have all my army I need at the control group. If I'm really panicking, then of course I use the all army hotkey, F2. But normally control group. Definitely control group. No boxes there.
No, that's, yeah. Because you need to do a concave in that moment. You need to do a little blog and
Oh
select,
yeah, of course. If
or
you do con you have to, otherwise it won't work. Sure.
do focus in the engage. You need to do a little blog or select a little select for to do a focus fire.
Yeah, if you
In that moment, I have problems because maybe I have a raven.
Yes.
I try to do a focus, but the raven is first with
That's
a.
yeah, that's why the Raven should never be in the same group with your main army. So I have my whole army on one, and the Raven and the Vikings on two, on the second control group. And then I move them individually. So the main army attack moves and the Raven normal moves, for example. Or I cast with the Raven and attack move, but they are never in the same selection. Because then exactly that what you just described happens. The Raven moves into the enemy and dies. So never have the Raven in the same group with your main army. Well, okay. Is there anything left before we close this today?
Yeah, thank you.
Anything, any questions left there?
No, it's okay.
Okay.
It's okay.
Okay.
Maybe the next time I like to practice more, maybe
Okay. I can maybe next time I find someone to play against, maybe on Europe, I don't know, but we definitely can do this, yes. And focus on your macro. I think if you really work on constant production, not focus too much on scouting. Of course you should scout, but not scouting here and micro there and damage with the Reaper. The Reaper, for example, in the replay you showed me. You were microing the Reaper against the Zerglings really well, but then back behind you had like 600 minerals. So switch the focus from your opponent to yourself and focus on yourself and your own base and your own macro. Not so much on your opponent. Have an eye on him. What is he doing? Is he attacking? But that's it. And focus on producing units all the time. Get the saturation done, get the upgrades done, get enough production facilities, produce, produce, produce. That's what you are. You are not a StarCraft 2 player, you are a producer. You produce units. That's what you
Okay.
should think all of the time. I am a producer and I produce units. And if I maxed on 10-minute mark, I did great. And then you go attack and do the drops, and then you kill him. Try it.
I
If it's
have a question. If
yes.
I see the enemy have a, for example, I have three tanks. How many tanks I have to do? If my enemy have maybe eight tanks, I have three tanks. With three tanks, I can attack, or I need to do the same.
It depends
Maybe eight.
on your marine count. If you have way more marines than he has, and it's on an open field, yes, you can attack. If he is in a defensive position, or you n would need to go through a ramp or anything like that, you can't attack him. If you have Vikings, maybe. But normally, no, you need to stay defensive. If he has that many tanks more and you don't have enough marines to counter that, no.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
Yes, you're welcome. I really do hope it helped you at least a little bit. And yes, next time, if you like, we can definitely do more Archon mode and more practice and more on the mechanic side.
Okay. I try to concentrate to macro. You have a reason. Is the basic of this game?
Macro, yes, definitely.
Yeah, it's the base.
So managing your own base and your resources and macro basically is the most important skill in StarCraft 2 you can have.
Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Nice.
Take care.
Okay.
See you.
See you the next time. Have a good one. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye bye. Thank you.